Well, greetings to all of you who are part of this live at 3:45 today. I'm delighted to have Melvin and Joaquina from Honduras and their son, Caleb, who is in the middle, who is a physician now, right, Caleb?
Almost
a physician. Okay, terrific. They have been longtime friends of our family and have visited many times. And God has been at work through them. And so I'm just inviting them to share whatever they want to share about their story and what God is doing. And Caleb is translating for us.
Hola.
Hi.
Qué bueno estar juntos esta tarde.
It's glad to be together this afternoon.
Le doy gracias a Dios porque a través de mi mamá.
I thank God because through my mother.
Yo pude conocer al Señor.
I was able to meet the Lord.
Ella conoció al Señor ella sola, prácticamente sola.
She knew the Lord by herself, basically.
Y nos llevó a la única iglesia cristiana que había en ese lugar.
And then she took us to the only Christian church that was in that place.
Y desde entonces he caminado con el Señor a través de todos estos años. Cuando tenía como unos 12 años.
That was about when I was 12 years old, and since then, all my life I've walked with the Lord.
En ese tiempo nosotros pertenecíamos a la Iglesia de la Asamblea de Dios. Y luego, cuando nos vinimos a vivir a San Pedro Sula, entonces conocimos de la Iglesia Menonita.
At that time, we were in our town. We went to a non-Mennonite church, but then when we moved to the city, we assisted to a Mennonite church.
Y ahí fue donde conocí a Melvin, y nos casamos y procreamos nuestros cuatro hijos.
And then in that church is where I met Melvin, my husband, and then we got married, and we have our four children.
Cuando cumplí los 50 años, el Señor me dio el pasaje de que todo este tiempo te he traído tomada de mi mano.
When I turned 50 years old, God put in my heart the Bible verse that says that during all this time, he has brought me from his hand.
Y así ha sido realmente para mí, ese es el testimonio que yo tengo que el Señor ha estado conmigo todos estos años y ha sido bueno para conmigo y me ha dado mucho más de lo que yo pensé que podía alcanzar.
I surely believe that God has been with me since that time and I have never missed anything. He has always fulfilled all of my necessities and my family also. He has been so good to me and to my life.
También he aprendido que la fe no se desarrolla desde el inicio. No es que tenemos toda la fe para creer en ese Dios tan grande y tan maravilloso. A través de los años nosotros lo vamos conociendo. Y es muy importante escudriñar las escrituras porque ahí es donde lo conocemos a él, cómo es él, cómo obra él.
I firmly believe that faith is not something that you just get once. It's something that you need to develop for a long time. When you read the Bible, when you pray, that's what I found out about the faith in my life. I have been developing it since I start first believing in God.
Comencé en la iglesia cuando muy joven dando clases de escuela bíblica a los niños los domingos.
My first job in the church was as a Bible teacher for the Sunday school for the children.
Y así creo que fui desarrollando como ese don de ser maestra. Me gusta más enseñar que predicar.
And then I guess that there's where my taste for the teaching started, because I like the most teaching than praying.
Y es hermoso servirle al Señor. Ha sido muy lindo todo este tiempo en que hemos atravesado muchos años ya. Hemos recorrido con Él en este camino, enseñando, predicando, tratando de que las personas puedan conocer un poco más al Señor.
The life in the Lord has been amazing. It's really beautiful how all this, for this very long time, I have walked with Him and I have teach many people. And then I have shown God's love to many others.
Ahora que estamos en este tiempo de pandemia, pues la iglesia está cerrada, el templo, digamos, como lo llamamos. Y sí me siento triste de ver que no lo podamos juntar. Yo sí anhelo estar en la congregación y ver a los hermanos y poder alabar y exaltar al Señor todos juntos.
In this pandemic time, it has been sad for me because I really loved gathering in the church with my brothers, praying together, worshiping God, listening to their testimonies, and I really missed that thing. Our church has been working just by Zoom meetings, during all the pandemic, since March from the last year.
Tenemos un grupo de mujeres líderes y ellas están a cargo de 5 o 6 damas de la congregación y las monitoreamos ahora pues a través del WhatsApp. Les envío videos, audios, perdón, para aquellas personas que no pueden conectarse vía Zoom. En las enseñanzas los días miércoles.
I also am in charge of the women's ministry in the church, and we have a group of leaders, and each leader has about 5 or 6 women from the church, and then I share sometimes some words, some videos, or some audios by WhatsApp. And that's the way I'm trying to reach those people who are not able to connect on Saturdays on our general meeting.
Y ahora en la escuela, pues sí estamos trabajando, digamos, a tiempo completo ya este año. Habemos 4 personas en la oficina que estamos ahí pues desarrollando nuestras labores. Igual, ¿verdad? Extrañando a los chicos que no pueden llegar a las instalaciones.
And also our church has a school. It has about 430 students. And also because of the pandemic, students are not able to be presently in the school for the classes. We are just working the teachers. They get to the school and they share the classes via Zoom to their students. And then the office personnel. We are 4 ladies working in the office. We really miss our students, seeing our children on the ground, playground.
Martina como yo venimos de familia que nacimos en pequeños pueblos a una hora de San Pedro.
We both come from small families that grew in small towns which are about 1 hour away from San Pedro Sula, which is the city where we live now.
Pueblos muy tradicionales católicos.
Very Catholic towns.
Y esa fue nuestra cultura de fe hasta los 16 años.
So we grew up as a child, as children, I mean, being next to the Catholic Church.
El alcohol, los bailes, una vida irrespetuosa.
So we saw like alcohol, gambling, many other non-Christian cultures.
Pero mi experiencia de la iglesia fue que todo eso cambió.
Then when I came to church, all of that changed.
El Señor Jesús entró en mi vida.
Jesus Christ came into my life.
Y fue un cambio. Mi vida fue otra de ahí en adelante.
Then that was like a new beginning. My life changed and it was totally different from that time on.
Junto con el perdón de pecados, mi salvación también vino la visión.
Together with my salvation and my sins were forgiven, but also the vision started there.
Y entiendo que desde ese día hasta este momento donde estamos frente a ustedes con algo que nunca nos pudimos haber imaginado.
And I believe that since that time until now that we are the three of us here in front of you guys through a camera, which is something that we never thought back then. We are entering to a plan which we don't understand, and it's a plan from God. Joaquina and I got in love in the church. We started making ministry together. We sang in the choir from the church.
In 1974,
we went to Lancaster, Pennsylvania, with the choir. We were invited by the Lancaster Choraliers or something.
Correct.
Not sure how.
And we're having a little trouble hearing him. So if he could maybe speak over this direction a little bit more.
Oh.
Y así fueron los planes. Llegamos a Estados Unidos, regresamos a la universidad, nos casamos con Joaquina, planificamos nuestros hijos.
So then that's how the plans were going. And we came back from the U.S., then we went to college, then we got married, then we planned our family.
Emprendimos negocios.
We started businesses.
Y en medio de todo eso, Dios nos llama al ministerio.
And in the middle of all that, then the Lord calls us to the ministry.
Asignándonos una pequeña congregación.
Giving us a very small congregation.
Abajo de un árbol de mango.
Under a fruit tree.
Con gente muy pobre.
With very poor people.
Y ahora que veo hacia aquellos días.
But now that I see back to those days.
Me doy cuenta que Dios puso su amor en nuestro corazón.
I found out that God really put his love in our hearts.
Y nos apartamos de la maldad.
And we went apart from evil.
El apóstol Pablo le dijo a Timoteo.
Paul said to Timothy.
El principio de todos los males.
That the beginning of every evil.
Es el amor al dinero.
Is the love to money.
Y el Señor Jesús.
And then Jesus Christ.
Cuando está hablando con el joven rico.
When he's talking with the rich guy.
Después de que él dice que ha cumplido todos los mandamientos.
After he says that he has already accomplished the commitments.
Jesús le dice que vaya, que venda todo lo que tenga y se lo dé a los pobres.
Jesus tells him that to go and sell everything he owns and give it to the poor.
Y entonces de esta manera nosotros trabajamos mucho en nuestras empresas.
And so this way we work very hard in our businesses.
Pero íbamos con aquel grupo de pobres a enseñarles la palabra.
We always gather with those poor people to share. share the world.
Y a compartir con ellos no solo la vida.
And to share with them not only life,
sino que también los recursos.
But also resources.
Y eso ha sido para nosotros el ministerio.
And that has been for us the ministry.
Empezamos desarrollando pequeños proyectos.
We started developing very small projects.
Y Dios los hizo en proyectos extraordinarios.
And God made them grow.
Aquel pequeño grupo de personas.
That very small group of people.
Que por 15 años no pasaron de 10.
That for 15 years there were not more than 10 people.
Pero en un periodo de 2 años pasó a más de 100.
And then suddenly in 2 years they turned out to be more than 100.
En un momento nos llama a hacer un pequeño albergue para el hijo de la madre soltera que trabaja.
Then in one time, God calls us to make a shelter for all those children, which they have single mothers and they work.
Y empezamos con 3 o 4 niños.
And then we started with 3 or 4 children.
Llegamos a 14 niños.
Then we get until 14 children.
Luego nos tuvimos que trasladar al edificio.
Then we had to change to another building.
5 de ellos no tenían otro lugar más que vivir con nosotros.
5 of those 14 didn't have any other place to live rather than with us.
Y los tenemos que llevar como los hijos de la iglesia.
And then we had to take care of them as sons from the church.
Y los estábamos criando en el patio.
We were raising them in our playground.
Y ahí en ese lugar.
And then in that place,
una de las niñas me pregunta que qué va a hacer, que ella tiene que ir a la escuela.
Then one of the little girls reached me and asked me, what am I going to do? I need a school now.
Y yo me quedo preocupado.
And then I felt worried about.
Porque llevar un niño desamparado a la escuela.
Because then I had to take a child to school.
Era llevarlo, traerlo.
It was taking him, bringing him back.
Uniformes.
Uniforms.
Merienda. Tareas,
homework,
reuniones de padres de familia,
parents meetings,
y estoy yo con mi cabeza que no sé qué hacer.
I was like troubled and I didn't know what to do.
¿Dónde hemos de tener tiempo para atender esta niña?
Where am I going to get the time to take care of this child?
Y el Señor pone en mi corazón.
Then the Lord puts in my heart.
Levanta una escuela.
Build up a school.
En ese momento suena el portón de la iglesia.
In that exact moment, somebody was on the door from the school, from where the school is now.
Y la niña corre hacia el portón.
Then the girl runs to the door.
Y ella me grita, son los gringos de Guaidó.
Then she claims, they're the gringos from White Dog.
Y entonces, ahí mi corazón me queda. La escuela será bilingüe y se llamará White Dove.
Then God put in my heart the name of the school, which was going to be White Dove, and then that it was going to be a bilingual school also.
Era un grupo de norteamericanos que iban de una iglesia en Nueva Orleans que se llamaba White Dove.
It was a group of missionaries that come from a New Orleans church named White Dove.
Que llevaban juguetes.
They brought toys for children.
Y de esta manera empezamos con el proyecto.
And then this is the way that we started with the project.
Y nos dedicamos ya a hacer iglesia y a hacer ministerio de educación. En el 2000.
That was in 2000. And then from then on, we started being church and also school.
Y desde entonces tratamos de desarrollar pastores en la iglesia.
And then since then we are working with growing pastors in the church.
Con una visión ministerial teológica, pero también centrados en la niñez.
With a biblical vision and also theologic, but also thinking of the children.
Un día leyendo una fracción de un libro del pueblo de Israel.
One day reading a book from the Israel people.
Un maestro le dice a un padre de familia.
A teacher tells to one parent.
Que no quería tener hijos.
That he didn't want children.
Los niños son más importantes que la Biblia.
But children are more important than the Bible.
Porque sin los niños la Biblia desaparecería.
Because without children, then Bible could disappear.
Porque el sentido de la Biblia es que se le enseña a los niños.
Because the sense of the Bible is that it be taught to children.
Cuando yo veo al pueblo de Israel,
when I see the Israel people,
recibiendo en el monte de Sinaí,
receiving in the Sinai Mount,
la palabra de Dios escrita,
the word of God written,
veo un proceso educativo.
I see an educative process.
No solamente un proceso espiritual.
Not only a spiritual process.
Dios le dio la ley a Moisés.
God gave the law to Moses.
Para que él se las enseñe.
For him to teach to them.
Y que los padres se la enseñen a los niños.
And then parents teach it to their children.
Las 24 horas del día.
24 hours a day.
Cuando entres, cuando salgas.
When you go in, when you go out.
Cuando te acuestas, cuando te levantes.
When you wake up, when you go to sleep.
Cuando vayas por el camino.
When you go in the way.
Te la vas a poner en las manos.
You have to put it in your hands.
En la frente.
On your forehead.
En el corazón.
On your heart.
En el dintel de las puertas.
In your doors.
Era toda una alfabetización.
There was a whole alphabetization.
Para todo el pueblo.
For the whole people.
La educación general aparece en Europa.
The general education shows up in Europe.
En los años 1700.
In the 1700s.
Pero la educación general del pueblo de Israel.
The general education of the Israel's people.
Es establecido 300 años antes de que viniera Jesús.
Was established about 300 years before Jesus came.
Y entonces, vine a creer yo que tener una institución educativa.
So I came to believe that having an education institute
cristiano,
Christian,
con un gran desarrollo de liderazgo,
with a huge leadership development,
y abrir las puertas de la iglesia para interrelacionarlos con otras culturas,
and open our church's door to have a relation with other cultures.
Y otros hermanos.
And other brothers and sisters.
Y así fue que Conrad conoció a Caleb a los 10 años.
That's how Conrad met me when I was about 12 or 13 years.
That's correct.
Y ahora la formación y la educación que Caleb recibió.
And now the education and formation that I received.
Nos está sirviendo para poder comunicar.
It's being useful to be able to communicate.
Y ampliar más el reino de los cielos.
And make grow the heaven's ministries.
Los males siempre se van a destruir.
Evil is always going to be destroyed.
Aunque vengan del amor al dinero.
Even if they come from money love.
Va a ser estableciendo el amor de Dios.
It will be setting God's love.
Y eso es lo que ha fluido entre nosotros.
And that's what has flown between us.
Que hemos conocido a Dios juntos.
We have known God together.
Hemos tenido comunión con Dios juntos.
We have had God. We have searched God together.
Y se va ampliando el reino de los cielos.
And that's how heaven's ministries grow.
Ha sido hermoso caminar con la iglesia menonita de Estados Unidos.
It has been wonderful to walk together with the Mennonite American Church.
Nos han alimentado con su fe.
We have been fed by them with their faith.
Y con su compañía.
With their love.
Hemos levantado unas 6 escuelas.
We have raised about 6 schools.
Con pastores.
With pastors.
Que tienen la misma visión.
Share the same vision.
Estamos llegando casi a unas 700 familias.
We are reaching about 700 families.
Y hemos ganado el corazón de muchas personas.
We have won the heart for many people.
A través de nuestro ministerio educativo.
Through our school ministries.
Y mantenemos siempre una gran relación.
We always keep a good relationship.
Con la iglesia menonita hondureña.
With the Hondurian Mennonite Church.
Y con la Iglesia Mennonita de Estados Unidos.
As well as the American Mennonite Church.
Y con varios amigos de África y de Asia.
And also with many friends from Asia or Africa.
Con quienes nos encontramos, y es una maravillosa experiencia espiritual volver a escuchar y a ver.
With whom we sometimes we have met, and which is always nice to hear from them and know about them.
Joaquina and Melvin, you have your vision always encourages us, and we've visited the school and church a number of times.
Su visión siempre nos ha motivado a nosotros y hemos visitado su escuela y iglesia.
And your deep faith in God is always an encouragement to us.
Y su profunda fe también nos ha animado.
And your commitment to the poor and to caring for the poor and the children is always an encouragement to us. How is the pandemic and the hurricanes, the two hurricanes that came through, how are you recovering from those? How have they impacted your work, your family, your lives?
Bueno, los huracanes sí hicieron mucho daño en el país.
Both of the hurricanes were very hard.
Hubieron colonias que quedaron totalmente inundadas, las casas que solo se les veía el techo.
We had many neighborhoods already flooded. We just we were only able to see the roofs of those houses.
Abrimos la escuela para tener ahí personas refugiadas que sus casas estaban inundadas. No eran miembros de la iglesia, eran personas que se conocían unas a otras y así fueron llegando.
We opened the school as a shelter for those families who had their houses flooded. They were not necessarily from the school nor from the church. We just opened the doors to people that we know that they needed somewhere to stay.
En ese tiempo, pues, se estuvo trabajando mucho en ayudar a estas personas y luego cuando ellos ya pudieron regresar a sus hogares, también tratamos de ayudarles de con provisiones para que ellos se sostuvieran por algún tiempo. Se les dio también asistencia médica mientras estuvieron en el albergue.
We opened our doors, we filled them, we gave them food, medical attention. We have them there for about 2 or 3 weeks. And then people was staying in our church, and then they went to their neighborhoods to clean their houses, and they came back at night to sleep. We received a lot of money for helping these people, thanks God. And we were able that when everything passed and they were getting back to their houses, we were able to give them some clothes, some money, some medicines.
De la congregación solo había como 3 familias que se inundaron y ellas también pues ya se les ayudó, ya están en sus casas, algunas de ellas, otras todavía no han podido regresar. Y hemos estado trabajando también ayudándole en Chamelecón, en la iglesia del pastor José. Algunas ayudas que nos vinieron a nosotros y que ya no teníamos, digamos, personas a quienes ayudarles, se las hemos pasado a esta área de Chamelecón porque ellos sí tuvieron muchos hermanos de la congregación que perdieron todos sus enseres en sus casas.
From our church, we only had about 2 or 3 families that were damaged. Thanks God. But then Chamelecón, you know, where Pastor Jose's church is, they were really flooded because they're very next to one of our principal rivers. And so we received so many aids, and then what we didn't need it, we were transferring it to Pastor Jose, because they got very flooded, lot of mud mostly, not only water. That's the problem with that. The hurricanes bring not only water but mud mostly. And then when it gets dry, when it, you know, it's like dirt. So
yeah.
A la fecha todavía hay personas que necesitan mucha ayuda porque necesitan hacer reconstrucción de sus casas y recuperar mucho de sus cosas, ¿verdad? Que perdieron, como refrigeradoras, estufas. Todavía hay un trabajo que hacer.
Right now, still at this date, there are still many people that still need help with their houses because they need to rebuild some walls. You know, their home goods, the fridge, the stoves, beds, all of that were lost because of the flood.
Somos el resultado de nuestras oraciones.
We are the result of our prayers.
He pensado muchas veces que uno ora para pedirle a Dios que haga las cosas.
We have thought that we pray God for him to make things.
Pero ahora que yo veo el tiempo pasar,
but now that I see the time pass,
me doy cuenta que uno ora para prepararse.
I find out that we pray
para
to get ready,
para comprender los planes de Dios.
To understand God's plans.
Nunca esperamos esta pandemia ni nunca esperamos estas inundaciones.
Never waited this pandemic nor the floods.
Pero las oraciones de los años anteriores,
the prayers from years before,
nos prepararon a nosotros
make us be ready
para poder enfrentar estos desafíos que venían.
To be able to overcome these trials.
Cuando yo miraba a Caleb en medio de los refugiados,
when I saw Caleb in the middle of the refugees,
siendo nuestro doctor, nuestro médico,
being our doctor,
era el resultado de las oraciones del año 2000.
It was the result of the prayers of 2001.
Cuando Paulita Velázquez está dando consulta dental,
and when he got Paola Velázquez giving dentistry aid.
Y me doy cuenta que estos chicos fueron preparados durante todo ese tiempo para este momento.
I found out that these kids were being prepared during all this time for that moment.
Habíamos empezado a estudiar hacía 2 años educación invertida.
Just 2 years ago, we had started studying the inverted education.
Y habíamos empezado a hacer encuentros virtuales con colegios de Israel.
And we have started making virtual encounters or meetings with Israel schools.
Y durante los últimos 2 años nos sentíamos muy contentos de lo que estábamos haciendo.
And during these last 2 years, we were feeling very happy of what we were doing.
Pero en el 2020, de un viernes a un domingo,
then last year, from one Friday to one Sunday,
que las escuelas ya no se pueden asistir y todo debe ser virtual.
We were told that everything was going to be started to go virtually and not presential.
Nos dimos cuenta que durante los años anteriores habíamos avanzado mucho para enfrentar ese momento.
And we found out that from the few years before, we have been getting ready for that moment.
Fue un gran reto que lo pudimos superar en 30 días prácticamente.
It was a huge challenge, but we could come over it in the first 30 days.
Y nuestro personal había entrado en un nuevo momento educativo.
Then our teachers had come into a new education model.
Y creo que fue el resultado de las oraciones de los años anteriores.
And then I believe that that was the result of all of those prayers from the years before.
Porque el llamado no es a conocer mucha teología.
because the call is not to know that much of theology,
sino a practicar obediencia.
But to practice obedience.
Y la fe es precisamente.
And then faith is precisely.
Es obedecer sin comprender.
Obey without understanding.
Sino que estar seguro que esa comunión con Dios.
Being sure that being with God.
Me lleva por el camino que Él desea.
Will take me the way that He wants.
Yeah, one of the things that always encourages me about listening to you is that you always see what's happening within the bigger picture of what God is doing. And I think it's so easy for us to lose sight of that picture of what God is doing.
You repeat what you said, Nairan.
Yes. So I'm always inspired by the way that the two of them see what God is doing. And that the difficulties are part of God's still at work. God's still at work in the difficulties. Thank you so much for being with us. We love you. Please give our regards to all of the White Dove Church and family, school. And we hope to get down to see you again. And you're always welcome here, you know.
Gracias. Thank you. Le rogamos mucho sus oraciones por nosotros.
I beg your prayers for us.
Yes.
Los tiempos que estamos viviendo son muy difíciles.
We're going through some difficult times right now.
Sin embargo, no queremos fallarle a Dios.
But even so, we don't want to miss God.
Queremos seguir amando como Él ama.
We are loving as He loves.
Y sirviendo como Él sirve. Yo recuerdo cuando aquella mujer rompió el perfume.
I remember when the Bible story, when that woman broke the perfume.
La gente había reclamado porque costaba mucho.
People was annoyed because they said it was expensive.
Pero Jesús dijo algo.
But Jesus said one thing.
Los pobres siempre los tendréis con vosotros.
Always have the poor among you.
Para bendecirles.
To bless them.
Y he aprendido.
And I have learned.
Que la más grande bendición del ser humano.
That the bigger blessing of the humanity.
Es tener la capacidad de darle al que necesita.
Is having the ability to share with those who need.
Creo que somos responsables.
I believe that we are responsible.
Los que tenemos algunas capacidades y recursos.
Those that we have some abilities and resources.
Del huérfano, de la viuda.
The poor,
del desamparado y del extranjero.
The foreigner.
Que es la mejor manera de mostrar el amor de Dios y la fe.
The will also, and that's the best way to show the love.
Y escapar un poco de las costumbres del mundo.
And run away from what the others keep doing.
De acaparar, de quitar.
To take away, to keep from for them.
De ser egoístas.
Being selfish.
Es hermoso compartir.
It's wonderful to share.
El amor de Dios.
Loves God.
Y tenerlos a ustedes como compañeros.
And having you as friends and mates in this mission.
Muchas gracias. Dios le bendigo. Dios le bendigo.
Gracias.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you, guests, for being here with us also. We will be back on Monday, and God's blessing and peace. Thank you.